his mouth dropped open, his eyes popped out. That was just a chaotic mishit by Pierlin. He's having no luck with the net at all, Edberg. He's had to play volleys off net cords, which have been difficult. That could have dropped over and didn't.
I thought it was a pivotal moment in the second set, maybe in the whole match, although the most crucial was when Edberg in the first set stumbled and twisted his left ankle. Right, is it, Bill? Right ankle?
Yep. That's his foot. That's his foot-faulting ankle. Josh, he stepped in and stabbed that one away in the old Edberg manner, didn't he? Pain or not. Another classic Edberg volley, fading that one on the forehand away. Feathering across the ball.
Well, one way or another, Stefan Edberg is just about in front in this second set. 4-3, Sweden lead, France one set to that.
He is clearly impeded.
3-4.
Oh! 12 out of the 16 games have had break points in. It's that sort of match. about his fastest attempt, 191k that serve. Knowledgeable crowd here. They know the importance of this point coming up. 15:30.
Come on. Was out by 30 inches. Surprised that Pearlene should have looked inquiringly at the side of the court.
34.
Well, here's a point and a half. This would leave Edberg serving for the set. Edberg, chip and charge.
Continues to be a stuttering performance, this, by Pearlene. Edberg won't go away, but then he never does.
Well, they met five times before. Pearlene would have expected that reaction from Edberg.
By one set to love. I suppose if it weren't the final of the Davis Cup, you'd say this was a fitful match.
Yes.
And if it weren't for the drama of the Edberg's injury, of course.
Huge French support by this crowd just below us here on the left. Now, tough game for Edberg, this one. 4-all, second set. Wonderful volley instincts from this man then to hit the ball back from whence it came instead of trying anything too elaborate. I'd like to see that one again. That's the sort of shot that gives a player real pleasure. Look at that right knee bent and driving through the ball down the line. Just a wonderful feeling for a player when he brings that one off.
Defensive lob threaded the rafters. I'm not quite sure.
No, he's pretty lucky because it...
high, aren't they?
Yeah, and it went higher than the rafters, so really lucky there, didn't hit them. Very high stadium, plenty of room for the lob.
Better timing, but again, you could see the way Edbo pulled up then on his right ankle. Well, having completed the volley, but he's still hurting it.
Not many players would have got their racket on this volley, so it's whipped back ferociously by Thielin. Edberg did terrifically well to hang his racket on it. Poor old Deuce.
Yes, that's it. That's the Edberg backhand volley. They don't come back when he snaps them like that. Not just the snap, it's the angle as well.
Yeah, and he's got to suffer the pain to close the net and to achieve the angle.